Hello students, in today's session we will start the first chapter of economics development. The main topics of the chapter are what development promises, different people, different goals. Second, income and other goals. Next, national development. Fourth, how to compare different countries or states, income and other criteria, public facilities, human development report, and the last one is that sustainability of development. Students, the idea of development or progress has always been with us. We have aspirations or desires about what we would like to do and how we would like to live. These are the aspirations of every person. Similarly, we have ideas about what a country should be like. What are the essential things that we require? Can life be better for all? How should people live together? Can there be more equality? Students, development involves thinking about these questions and about the ways in which we can work towards achieving these goals. This is a complex task. So in this chapter, we shall make a beginning at understanding development. Again, development is an idea of a person regarding an individual or about country. So, developmental ideas are about an individual or about a country. Now, examples of development. The definition of development is interpreted by different people in different ways. Let's see the interpretation of different people. According to a layman, development is building of big industries, dams, introduction of new technology, etc. For him, development is big building, big industries, dams, new mode of transport, new technology, nothing else. He sees only these things. And he sees these are development. For a farmer, his developmental goal is different. For him, development means better irrigation because he needs irrigation and good price for his crops. That is his development. See the difference between these two people about development. One sees only big industry, dams as development. The other one sees development as better irrigation and a good price for his crops. Now the third one, tribals. You know, tribals, they see development as banning the construction work in their area. They wanted to have no dams there. They wanted to have traditional mode of irrigation for their crops. That is their development. From these discussions of development, we can conclude the notion of development as different people have different ideas about development. What may be development for one may not be development for other. It may be destructive for the other. It is very clear from the example that for more electricity, industrialists may want more dams. Construction of dams may be good for industrialists, but that may be destructive for the tribal people. How? Do you know, children? Construction of dams submerge hectares of land. That may be agricultural land or forest land, and disrupt the lives of poor people who are displaced from there. So these dams are not favorable or developmental for tribal people. At the same time, these dams are destructive for these people, but construction dams are good for industries. See, the development of one may not be the development of other. Sometimes it may be destructive for the other. Another example. For a miner, mining gives more income to miner. But at the same time, the people living near mines, that is destructive. How is it? You know, mining activities pollute the environment, pollute water of the surrounding areas, and that degrade land, that leads to deforestation. So for miner, mining is good, that is developmental for him, that increases his income. At the same time, the same mining activity destroys the life of thousands of people. So development of one may not be the development of the other, and it may even be destructive for the other. Establishment of dams means construction of dams is the development for the industries. As he get more electricity, but that shatter the lives of tribals who are displaced. So construction dams is developmental for industries. At the same time, that shatter the lives of thousands of innocent tribal people. Next topic is income and other goals. See how income matters our life. You know that the role of income in our life is very important. Without money, we cannot survive. And besides income, we need some other things also in our life. Money is not everything, but without money, we can't buy anything. That is the fact. Besides seeking more income, one way or the other, people seek things besides income. People seek things like equal treatment, freedom, security, and respect of others. These are the things which cannot buy money. Money cannot buy these things, but these things are essential in one's life. So money can buy only material things. Money cannot buy non-material things. The quality of one's life depends on non-material things also. the non-material things such as friendship, equal treatment, security, then clean environment, etc., which are essential for one's life. Goals other than income on which development depends are these things. These are the goals other than income on which our life depends. These things cannot be measured. Which things? Friendship, security, clean environment, equal treatment. These things cannot be measured. These are unmeasurable. But they mean a lot in our lives. The value of these things in our life is much more. Next is that before accepting a job, people look a mix of goals. It happens in everybody's life. Before accepting a job, people look many things. First thing is that income, because income is the main factor. Besides income, what are the other things one should look towards his job? Facilities for family, working atmosphere, security of job. These things are essential. Another thing is that a job may give less pay but provide all the above things. A job pays less but provides security, regular job, good working atmosphere, paid leaves are there, facilities are providing, then people may accept even if that job pays less. Another circumstance is that a job pays high salary, but there is no security of job, there is no leave, and there is no time for family. That may reduce a sense of security and freedom. So some people accept the second case because of having high income. They may be attracted towards high salary even if they are not getting any other facilities. They see only high salary. Even if not getting time for their family, they will be agreeable because of high pay packages. At the same time, some people see only good working atmosphere, security of jobs, even if their salary is very less. So these are mix of goals. Similarly, for development, people look at these different goals. And it is also true that if women are engaged in paid work, their dignity in the household and the society increases, no doubt. If women are engaged in paid jobs, they get dignity in the household as well as in the society. But it is also the case that if there is respect for women, there would be more sharing of housework and a greater acceptance of women working outside. Then only the women can work outside. These conditions are essential for her work outside. A safe and secure environment may allow women to take up a variety of jobs or run a business. For accepting variety of jobs or running business, women should need a safe and secure environment. So we can conclude here that the development goals that people have are not only about better income, but some other important factors also consider here. People do not work only for income. They seek to have some other things which are essential for their life, such as security, freedom, respect, clean environment, friendship, etc. So these are development goals. Once again, development goals of different people are different. The development goal of one may not be the development goal of other. Sometimes it may be destructive. Okay, students, that's all for today.